Our big story tonight. Voting in the presidential elections has concluded in Sri Lanka. An unprecedented 35 candidates had put in their names for the top post in the island nation. Over 80% of eligible voters polled in today's election to elect a new leader, a new president for Sri Lanka. This was a record voter turnout registered in Sri Lanka, and there were enough reasons for the voters to come out and put to use their franchise. The elections are the first to be carried out in Sri Lanka since the Easter Sunday bombings in April that killed over 250 people. The shadow of the deadly attack looms large over these elections. No doubt that national security is a prominent issue in Sri Lanka. National security is the plank that Gotabaya Rajapaksa has based his presidential campaign upon. Gotabaya is the younger brother of former President Mahinda Rajapaksa. He was also a defense secretary in his brother's cabinet and is known for ending the civil war. He, however, faces accusations of human rights violations in the war against LTTE and charges of corruption. Gotabaya appeared extremely confident as he cast his vote, saying that the people of Sri Lanka will get a better future under his presidency. His main rival in these elections is Sajith Premadasa, the current housing minister. Sajith, too, hails from a political family. He is the only son of former President Ranasinghe Premadasa. He based his campaign on social welfare and the extension of government schemes to all sections of society. The polling process was, however, not entirely smooth. Incidents of violence were reported in different parts of the country. Shots were fired at a convoy of Muslims while they were headed to cast their ballot in the northern district of Mannar. The Election Commission has acknowledged that its travel arrangements for the Muslim voters in Mannar were not up to the mark. Another official in the poll panel went on to say that there was a concerted effort to keep the Muslims away from the ballot box. Despite such incidents, the votes have been cast and the ballot boxes sealed. The candidate who gets over 50% of the votes will become the president. If there is no clear mandate, the president will be chosen on the basis of preference votes. Now, the Indian director in the India-Sri Lanka Foundation, Mr. G. Parthasarathy, is now joining us live on this broadcast for more on the all-important Sri Lankan presidential election. Sir, Mr. Parthasarathy, thank you so much, as always, for taking time out to be with us here on Wion World is One. First up, your thoughts, a crucial, momentous election for Sri Lanka with a massive voter turnout.
Well, you know, one thing about Sri Lanka, it's about the most vibrant democracy in the Indian Ocean. Having been there, one has seen it's really a deep-rooted democracy. But it's interesting that there is also dynastic politics. Of the two presidential candidates, Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa is the brother of former President Mahinda Rajapaksa, both belonging to, who earlier belonged to the left-wing Sri Lanka Freedom Party before they set up their own political outfit. Then you have Sajith Premadasa, whose father, President Premadasa, was incidentally killed by the LTTE in 1993. And he's interesting because his father made a mistake of cultivating the LTTE and he paid a very heavy price for it. I think the important thing is that you are going to have an interestingly divided electorate. Mr. Premadasa unquestionably enjoys the support of the minority Tamils and the Muslims. Gotabaya and his brother have a reputation, I wouldn't say a track record, that would be unfair, within Sri Lanka itself as being pretty hardline when it comes to the Tamils and Muslims, especially the case of the Muslims after the April 21 riots this year. So it is going to be a close election. It is a vibrant democratic process. I think the external factors, you would find that the right-wing UNP leans towards the United States, whether it is the present Prime Minister or young Mr. Premadasa. himself has had his election in the US. The other party, the Rajapaksas, have built up a reputation for close relations with China. In fact, the Rajapaksa thing went so far that the investment in their own constituency by the Chinese led to a debt trap and handing over of the Hambantota port to China. And so I think their party also, I wouldn't say that the present right. president, Mr. Sirisena...
At this stage, if I were to ask you, going into polling day, the Rajapaksa camp was hit with the nationality row that is still in the courts of Sri Lanka. How much of an impact do you think that's going to have on the Sri Lankan presidential elections?
That will come late in the day, because the question is really Mr. Rajapaksa, the younger Mr. Rajapaksa, was an American national. He had dual nationality. But with dual nationality, he would not be eligible to stand for president. He claimed to have renounced his American nationality, but the Sri Lankan media has been raising doubts. But, you know, the Sri Lankan courts are quite independent. So if that that will this be an issue which will be examined in due course.
Right. Now, I was asking in terms of, you know, how much do you think is going to play in the minds of the Sri Lankan voter? What do you think really the mood is in Sri Lanka, especially after the bombings of churches and hotels in April?
You know, what surprised me was that Sri Lanka for years had been such a vibrant economy. But when I was there on my last two visits, I found the first signs of the country coming under economic strain. They had gotten into a lot of projects with China and others. Tourism had fallen this year, including Indian tourists, for different reasons after the communal riots. I think the economy will be an issue. How far it will go remains to be seen. But certainly Sajith Premadasa has been campaigning on an economic platform. But one shouldn't underestimate also the influence of the Rajapaksas, because widely in Sinhala eyes, they are seen as the leading the country out of their prolonged civil war and the ethnic conflict. So it's going to be a close run, yeah.
It's going to be a close run, and it's going to be extremely crucial for India, you know, at this stage in terms of the state of play in Sri Lanka with a major Chinese influence. The leadership that Sri Lanka appoints for itself is going to have a huge impact on the bilateral relationship with India.
Well, I think by and large, we've tried to keep this our policy towards them, you know, and I have been a firm advocate of their, of not getting involved in their internal politics. And I think Mr. Rajapaksa knows the price which he had to pay for leaning too heavily in one direction in terms of his loss in the last elections by a candidate, President Sirisena, who belonged to the same party that Mr. Rajapaksa once was. And really, there does seem to be some reconciliation between the two, because the Prime Minister is Ranil Wickremesinghe, is from a what is generally considered as a rightist party, but I think that's an unfair description, which is more conscious of keeping the minorities along. So it's going to be close. Both candidates, one much younger, than the other, in the 60s and in the 50s, 70s and the 50s. So it's an interesting election. We can, as an Indian, all I can say is we wish India, Sri Lanka well as a democracy. It's been a robust democracy with a very unfortunate ethnic conflict. We hope we get over it and become stable. But at the same time, we hope there will be due diligence in conduct of foreign policy. They've landed themselves in a debt, especially with China spending much more than they should.
Absolutely.
But that's not a country that Sri Lanka experience, that Sri Lanka owners felt. Pakistan is feeling it. And at least 20 African countries are feeling it now. So certainly China comes with very colorful infrastructure projects.
Right.
But countries are now learning to be more careful in weighing the death right. consequences.
G. Parthasarathy joining us on this broadcast with that invaluable perspective on the Sri Lankan elections. Thank you so much for being with us here on We On World is One.